Happy birthday, Hubble! It's the Hubble Space Telescope's birthday. Well, technically it's the anniversary of its launch, but don't yuck my yum of anthropomorphizing space robots that help us do good science, okay? We did it with the Mars rovers, I'm going to do it with the telescope as well. The Hubble Space Telescope was launched into space on this day, the 24th of April in 1990, 35 years ago. And in honor of its 35th birthday, we're going to go through the 35 top-ranked images on the ESA Hubble Image Library website. And trust me, there's something for everyone in the top 35 ranked images. Just don't ask me how they rank them, because I don't know. But before we get into the pictures, here are some wild number facts I just learned about Hubble that blew my mind. First of all, a USB stick these days has more storage space than the Hubble Space Telescope. Hubble can store about 3 gigabytes of data at its maximum. Hubble has also done over 1.6 million observations of over 108 million objects in space, and yet it has only observed approximately 0.1% of the entire sky. But that's enough numbers, let's get into the pictures. Coming in at number 35 is this, Hubble's view of the spiral galaxy Messier 106. But fun fact about this picture specifically, Hubble wasn't the only telescope used to create this image. It's actually combined with additional information captured by amateur astronomers and their Earth-based telescopes. How fun! And number 34 is actually an anniversary celebration image from when Hubble turned 31 back in 2021. And I have to admit, I don't think I've ever actually seen this image before. It's a picture of one of the brightest stars seen in our galaxy, the Wolf Rayet star AG Carinae. Now, Wolf Rayet stars are some of the most extreme stars in the universe. They're very hot, very massive, and because of this, they don't last very long, no more than about 10 million years. And trust me, that's nothing for a star's lifetime. Our sun's going to live for 10 billion years. Anyway, this one in particular is gorgeous. The details in the expanding shell of dust and gas are so interesting. And by the way, this shell is about 5 light years wide. So that's a little bigger than the distance to the nearest star to our solar system. Moving on to number 33, we've got a lot to get through, so we're going to speed through some of these. It is Saturn in natural colors. Apparently, image processing specialists worked hard on this image to make it as close to true color as they could. So I guess if you went in a spaceship closer to Saturn, this is the closest to what you should expect to see. Now, number 32 is a little cheeky, depending on how you look at it. This is a section of the Carina Nebula, around 8,000 light years away from us. Now, humanity is a wonderful thing, especially with how we find patterns in weird places, like this caterpillar down at the bottom of the image, or my favorite, this blob of gas and dust that clearly looks like TikTok the crocodile from Peter Pan. Wait, what did you think it looked like? Coming in at number 31 is the Red Spider Nebula. It's a planetary nebula, so it represents the death of a star similar to the sun. The leftover core of that now dead star, called a white dwarf, is what's driving the dust clouds to look like that. How cool! But we've got more to explore, so let's move on to number 30. It is the Mice Galaxies. This is a picture of two galaxies that are in the process of merging together and ripping each other apart in that process. Now, whenever I talk about merging galaxies, I often get thrown the question, but how can galaxies merge together if the universe is expanding? And the short answer is that gravity is dominant and stronger than the expansion of space on small scales like the distances between galaxies. Yes, compared to the size of the universe, the distances between galaxies is short. It's all relative. Anyway, moving on. We have another warped galaxy coming in at number 29 of the ranked images on the Hubble Image Library website. This is the Tadpole Galaxy, and this long tendril is the result of a smaller galaxy falling into this larger galaxy. Now, because the larger galaxy has more stars and therefore more mass and stronger gravity, it's able to retain its shape better than the smaller galaxy that just got ripped apart as it fell through the larger galaxy. Changing tunes with number 28, we're back inside the Milky Way galaxy, looking at something a little spooky, but it's actually really beautiful. This is a place where stars are born. It's called the Cone Nebula because the whole structure looks like a cone, and this is just the tip though, the 2.5 light year long tip of the cone. Number 27 is one of my top favorites. This is NGC 1300, a gorgeous barred spiral galaxy. I don't have much to say about it, so just look at it. It's also one of the largest images ever made by Hubble. Next at number 26 is the classic light echo image. You don't really get much of it from the one capture here, but when you look at the images taken of this object just months apart in the same year, you can actually start to see and appreciate this light echo. The star at the center of this echo had a burst of energy, and that has illuminated the dust surrounding it over time as it has traveled out from the star. Now, Hubble is capturing space in motion within a lifetime, and it is awesome. Back to galaxies at number 25 with cosmic dust bunnies. This is an elliptical galaxy, and it's often the exact image I use to show the difference between spiral galaxies and elliptical galaxies because it's got some character to it with these little dust clouds around it. Fun fact, these dust lanes provide evidence that this galaxy was formed from a past merger of two gas-rich galaxies. Now, number 24 goes to the classic Whirlpool galaxy, a typical spiral galaxy. But with this one, it kind of looks like one of its spiral arms is reaching into the more yellow galaxy to its side, when in fact, this yellow galaxy is passing behind the Whirlpool galaxy. Its gravity is still influencing the Whirlpool galaxy, but they're not touching despite how it looks to the untrained eye. Next, we have the Eagle Nebula in the Milky Way galaxy, which is just absolutely epic. It's another place where stars are being born. At number 22, we have another place where stars are being born, but not in the Milky Way. Instead, this one is in one of our nearest galactic neighbors, the Small Magellanic Cloud. Number 21 is my personal favorite from Hubble, and it's actually the Hubble image that inspired me to become an astrophysicist. It's Hubble's sharpest view of the Orion Nebula. This is yet another place where stars are born, and you can see this object as a smudge in the dagger of Orion with your own eyes from places with little light pollution. Changing gears from stellar birth to stellar death at number 20 with the beautiful Butterfly Nebula. This is another planetary nebula which marks the death of stars like our sun, except this one is estimated to have been about 5 times the mass of our sun. Now, when we look at the image, we're basically seeing the dramatic breakup story of a dying star. It started off by ballooning into a massive red giant about 1,000 times the size of our sun. Eventually, it shed its puffy outer layers. Some of that gas drifted off to form around its equator pretty gently, well, gentle by cosmic standards, at around 32,000 kilometers per hour, forming a donut-like ring. But then things started to get a bit more intense, when other material was blasted out at high speeds from the pole of the star, making these long wing-like structures that give it that iconic butterfly shape. And just when you thought it was done, nope. As the star's core heated up, it sent out a much faster stellar wind, clocking in at over 3.2 million kilometers per hour that slammed into all that previously ejected gas, reshaping the whole thing even more. At number 19, we have another barred spiral galaxy, but this one is special because in 2009, we saw a star explode in this galaxy. See this bright spot to the top upper right of the center of the galaxy? This is the result of a white dwarf star exploding after it gobbled up too much of its companion star. At number 18, and we're almost halfway, we have another anniversary picture from Hubble's 28th birthday showing the Lagoon Nebula. This is another place where stars are born. The whole region is approximately 55 light years wide and 20 light years tall, but this image shows a section of the star-forming nebula that's just about 4 light years across. We have another stellar death at number 17, but finally it's from a more dramatic stellar death. You've probably seen this object before. It's called the Crab Nebula, and it was formed from the death of a massive star that exploded in a supernova at the end of its life, leaving behind this gorgeous cloud of stellar destruction. Now, what I love about this object so much is that we have written records from ancient Chinese astronomers who observed its death in 1054. Number 16 doesn't have a cool name. It's called N90, but it's another star-forming region in our galactic neighbor, the Small Magellanic Cloud. Beautiful. Moving on, we've got another portrait of Saturn at number 15. The fact that Saturn has come up twice now in this top 35 ranking is amazing because it's just such a gorgeous planet. Like, look at those stunning rings. This image of Saturn was taken on the 20th of June in 2019 when it made its closest approach to Earth in that year at approximately 1.36 billion kilometers away. Number 14 goes to one of my favorite galaxies out in the universe, the Sombrero Galaxy. Not only because it looks kind of like a sombrero, but it's also just a really interesting galaxy that blurs the line a little bit between spiral and elliptical galaxies, with its extended bright bulge giving elliptical vibes and its thin dust lane giving more of a spiral identity. Either way, it is stunning. The next one is honestly kind of meh when you look at it in comparison to some other photos, but when you start to dissect this image, this galaxy becomes much more interesting. This is NGC 1792, and it's a starburst galaxy forming a lot more stars than typical galaxies. The Milky Way creates stars at a rate of around 2 suns per year on average. This one is closer to the equivalent of 11 suns per year. Number 12 goes to the Hubble Ultra Deep Field. This is an image of the sky that's equivalent to the size of a grain of sand held at arm's length, so teeny tiny, and it reveals approximately 10,000 galaxies. In order to reveal that many galaxies that far back in the history of the universe, Hubble had to stare at this piece of sky for a total time of 11.3 days. How amazing. At number 11, we have the magnetic monster NGC 1275. It's a safer galaxy, which is one of the most energetic types of galaxies in the universe with very active cores. And this one has a strong magnetic field traced by these red tendrils that stretch for almost 200,000 light years. Here we go, we're on the final stretch now. Coming in at number 10, we have a great image that shows what Hubble can really do. And that's not just reveal the universe from the visible light that we can see, but also from light that we can't see. This is the Horsehead Nebula seen by Hubble in infrared light, light that's redder than red. This was also released as an anniversary image for Hubble's 23rd birthday. And number 9 is another pair of interacting galaxies called the Antennae galaxies, a gorgeous example of the craziness of space and the beauty of destruction caused by the crashing together of galaxies, especially gassy spiral galaxies like these two were. See all that hot pink looking splotches? That's where the gases from these two galaxies have interacted together as they merge together, causing new stars to form in a massive starburst. Coming in at number 8 is a cosmic bubble. This image made it as one of my desktop backgrounds back in the day. This is the Bubble Nebula, and it is a type of nebula we haven't strictly come across yet in our countdown. It's an emission nebula, so the gas that this cloud is made of is emitting light because it has been energized by activity around it. In this case, the bubble has been carved out from this cloud of gas from the star at the center of the bubble, and the activity from the star itself also causes it to glow. How cool is that? Number 7 goes to a beautiful star cluster and star-forming region that goes by the name of NGC 3603. Scientists estimate that this cloud of gas went through a big round of star formation around 1 million years ago, creating this massive star cluster in the center. Number 6 goes to this lovely spiral galaxy. Fun fact about this one, we saw a supernova go off in this galaxy, and Hubble captured a time lapse of the supernova fading after it exploded. Check it out. Here we go, top 5. Number 5 goes to this awesome wobble of space. This is a great example of gravitational lensing, where the sheer mass of a cluster of galaxies in the foreground bends and warps the light from a more distant galaxy in the background. Look at how it wobbles, it's amazing. I absolutely love number 4. This is the Pillars of Creation. It's another place where stars are born, and it is truly one of the most iconic images taken by Hubble. This is its view in visible light, but I do prefer the infrared version of Hubble's view of the Pillars of Creation. Just by the way, the scale of these pillars is huge. They're about 5 light years tall. Okay, the 3rd highest ranked image on the Hubble Image Library website goes to another anniversary image for Hubble's 25th birthday 10 years ago, Westerlund 2. This one also made it as one of my desktop wallpapers back in the day. I love all the colors, even the composition of the gas in the bottom left and the star cluster shining brightly near the middle. It's just an incredible image all around. Number 2 goes to yet another previous desktop wallpaper and smartwatch wallpaper too. These two clouds of gas belong to the Large Magellanic Cloud, another galactic neighbor of the Milky Way, and they're forming stars. And finally, it's time to reveal the highest rated image taken by Hubble on the Hubble Image Library website. What do you think? Will it go to a nebula? Will it go to a galaxy or a planet maybe? Let's have a look. It's Jupiter. Wow, I can't, I'm lost for words. I can really see why this is the top ranked Hubble image. Just look at that detail of Jupiter. You've got the great red spot right in front and center. You've also got Europa, one of Jupiter's moons, hanging out in the picture too. It's just incredible. There you have it. Those are the top 35 ranked images taken by Hubble on the Hubble Image Library website. What was your favorite? Or is your favorite one that wasn't in the top 35? Leave your answers in the comments. And happy birthday, happy 35th birthday, Hubble. I look forward to hopefully at least another decade of more pretty space pictures and awesome discoveries before you eventually fall back to Earth in the mid-2030s at the earliest. Fingers crossed for longer. Until next time, stay curious and keep looking up.